During the previews, a trailer came up for a movie which caught my eye, a trailer advertising the film Hardcore Henry. It showed off all the crazy action and stunts, but it also showed off the first-person perspective it was in. My first thought was, damn it, I had an idea for a first-person action film, and this motherfucker stole it. Someone called the YouTube copyright system, because this
Because
is
this is
war.
war.
My second thought was what probably everyone thought when they saw this trailer. Huh. I don't know if they can pull off a perspective like this while keeping it interesting and coherent. Despite my doubts, I desperately wanted to see this movie, mostly out of mere curiosity. Eventually, the film came to Redbox, and my father was kind enough to rent it for me. Thanks, Dad. I saw the film, and I was like, huh, that was something. Then I watched it again, and I freaking loved it. Then I bought the Blu-ray, where I watched it again, watched the director's commentary, and then the director-actor commentary. After all those rewatches, it is my opinion that Hardcore Henry is one of the greatest action films of our time, and your first order of business should be to find an official Blu-ray copy if you can, and buy it. Why? Well, let me tell you why. Let me tell you why Hardcore Henry is awesome. Roll credits. The first aspect to talk about is the story. You watch from the point of view of a man named Henry, who wakes up being taken care of by his wife, Estelle, with some of his limbs being replaced with robotic ones. Suddenly, the villain of the film, Aiken, breaks in, steals Henry's wife, and throws him off a bridge. Now, Henry must save his wife with the help of the mysterious quest-giver Jimmy, beat the final boss, save the princess, and kill lots. And lots and lots of fools on the way there. Yeah, so I'll be the first to say that if you're looking for a deep, complex story, you're not going to find it here. Besides the fact that it's basically a first-person shooter, the story also feels like a video game in of itself. The whole movie is basically Henry going from objective to objective and killing everyone on the way there, with his only companion being Jimmy, played expertly by Charlton Copley for reasons I'll get into in a bit. Not helping matters is the fact that while some of the humor is funny, the other parts rely on things those annoying 12-year-olds on Xbox Live find funny. All that being said, I'd argue that a film like Mad Max Fury Road had just the deepest story, and that film is praised to hell and back. Drive this way. Oh, there's nothing here? Okay, let's go back. To be honest, while I like myself a good narrative, the story is simple enough that I can just kinda go along with it. There are some neat twists and turns, especially near the end, and honestly there's so much other good stuff that overshadows this weaker element, one of those being the characters. Now, it may not look like it, but Henry himself is in fact a character, despite the fact that he doesn't speak. Director Ilya Naishuller says it best in this interview.
You use his hands? His movements, where he looks and where he doesn't look at also says a lot about the character. His choices that he makes in the film are what sells the character. It's challenging, but yeah, hopefully it works.
And it's true. We see that Henry is just a confused man, unsure of the world. All he knows is that his wife loves him and he has to go get her back.
Hopefully there's some character in
there. There is a little bit.
Yeah.
He's got a name.
If not, there's a lot of different Jimmys. Just watch me. Yeah. It's fine.
Yes, the real star of the film is none other than Charlton Copley as Jimmy. Jimmy is your companion on this quest and your main source of info, help, and comedy all at once. To avoid spoilers, I won't go into too much detail, but let's just say that because of the world invented by Naishuller, Charlton is able to show off various of his...
It's me, Jimmy. Move.
So fired up some of this shit! Fried my fucking nerves, yeah!
Hey, Henry, put your gun down! It's all good!
Acting talents. Thanks to this, Jimmy is always a thrill to watch. Every time he's on screen, the film just becomes better as you see what crazy personality is here this time. Aside from Jimmy, the only other real characters are Estelle and the main villain, Aiken. I'm not gonna act like this is the best bad guy since Heath Ledger as the Joker. In fact, a lot of his humor is rather...
Dick.
Cringy, but when he has to be a dickhead and he has to be menacing, he really is a commanding presence on screen. He's got a unique look that differentiates him from everyone else in the film. His way of speaking makes him more interesting and memorable. and his personality is tailor-made to be hateable, but in a fun kind of way. He taunts and toys with Henry time and again the entire film, and it helps that he's an actual physical threat to him. He's a perfect love-to-hate kind of villain. Both he and Jimmy command the screen, and they're always fun to watch. But let's talk about what you really came here for, the first-person point of view.
Do tell.
This has been a turnoff for some people, as either they get motion sick easily or simply dismiss the idea as gimmicky. This is certainly a valid complaint, but one that the director fixes in the first 10 minutes. He understands that seeing this perspective for the first time on the big screen can be very jarring for audiences. That's why a lot of time is spent easing us into this point of view, slowly but surely getting us adjusted. Some of the film can be a little shaky, but you adjust quickly, and despite the unique perspective, you're always aware of what's happening around you, unlike some other films and shows that are shot traditionally yet they're filmed like they're on a tilt-a-whirl. That becomes useful when in the final battle, we're doing this. Which brings me to one of the biggest points on why you should watch this film, that being the action. And, oh god, the action. I say this without a hint of sarcasm. Hardcore Henry has some of the best action in an action film. Period. It stands along the greats like Mad Max and The Raid when it comes to awesome high-octane battles. All the fights and encounters in this film are unique from each other and always a joy to view. There's never any repeat encounters, and each one is worth the price of admission alone. As much as I love Mad Max and The Raid for their action scenes, they do have some sequences that blend together. Done well, they just resemble their earlier fights somewhat. With Hardcore Henry, not one action scene is repeated. There's a perfect mix of fist fights, knife play, gunplay, parkour, and so much more. Obviously, these fight scenes share elements like guns and punching and stabbing, but they're executed differently and creatively enough that there's always something new the film throws at you. Which is funny because if you think about it, it's not technically doing much new. We have a chase scene, an escape scene, a sneaking in scene, but it's here where the POV comes into play. All these scenes are made far more intense when we're put into Henry's shoes as he stabs fools 1 second, then shoots them the next. And it gets down the fundamentals of action perfectly. The velocity. The impact. The skill. The tension. And the overall flashiness of it all. Every single encounter in this film executes marvelously on all these factors. And the best part is that, much like the video games that inspired it, it perfectly escalates the action so that the next fight scene is more bombastic, more nail-biting, and more exciting than the last. We start out with a simple brawl, and we move our way up to the final battle where Henry's skills are put to the ultimate test. With all of these elements combined, Hardcore Henry violently carves its place in film history as the best of the best in terms of action. It really is a joy to see it all come into fruition, damn near perfectly. Of course, the action is executed by what I am convinced is the best stunt crew that will ever exist, and more evidence that the Oscars need to add a stunt category, because this film absolutely would have won. While much action nowadays occurs inside of a computer or among a flurry of cuts and angle changes, Hardcore Henry lives up to its name and pulls no punches, literally.
Бей меня. Бей меня вот со всей силой. Он пару раз влупил мне, у меня образовалось.
When you see a man falling out of a bus while being set on fire, he really is falling out of a bus while being set on fire. When Henry has to jump off a tumbling van and land on a motorcycle going at blazing speeds, he really has to do just that. When a goddamn tank is mere feet away from completely crushing Henry, well, you get the idea. While Hollywood is still giving us thrilling action scenes like this. Nyshuler is giving us this. Eleven cuts to have an old man jump a fence, versus much fewer to completely destroy a minivan. Pick which one you like more. All these stunts are enhanced by expertly handled CGI. I hate to keep bringing up Ilya Naishiller, but goddammit, he's a friggin' underrated genius and I'll give him as much exposure as he needs. Anyways, he knows that the best action is actually done in front of the camera. CGI is used sparingly, and in subtle touches where you wouldn't even notice it's there. Not just adding things like explosions and gunshots, but also removing things like wires and shadows. Very rarely is CG used up front, and the film is all the better for it. Now listen, I don't despise CG, in fact I feel like too many people give it a hard rap, but it's all about how it's handled. Sometimes you're gonna need to CG a man being blown to a million pieces, or having him get eaten by a shark, because doing it for real would be unethical is the word some use. However, if you can afford to, say, flip a minivan, then why not take the opportunity? It looks better anyways. There's one last thing that makes the action so memorable, and it is the soundtrack. The soundtrack are the sprinkles on this action cake. The score by Dasha Charusha has a fast-paced techno vibe that perfectly suits the world of Hardcore Henry and the action that accompanies it. It's fast-paced when it needs to be fast-paced, it's stylish when it needs to be stylish, and most importantly, it pumps you up when you need to be pumped up. The song choice is also excellent, ranging from fast-paced punk rock to stylish mellow tunes that contrast with the film, but in a good way. The highlight is, of course, Don't Stop Me Now by Queen, but there's other awesome ones as well, specifically by Naishiller's own band. These include the song which plays during the car chase, My Woman, and the end credits song, For the Kill. The score elevates the action and turns the film into not just a visual treat, but an audio one as well. Now, I've gone over a lot on why you should watch this film. The action, the characters, the crazy stunts, use of CG, and the music. But despite all these reasons on why this movie is awesome, there's another that I haven't brought up. And yet, I feel it's the most important. That reason is risk. Look at the slate of films that are coming out this year. Look at the slate of films that came out last year, the year before that. Look at the films coming next year. Sequels, reboots, remakes, films part of recognizable brands, films part of a franchise, films based on pre-existing material, a goddamn emoji movie, for Christ's sake. In other words, films that are safe, films that don't require innovation, and films that don't take risks. Not all these movies are bad, in fact, many of them are downright brilliant, but it's no secret that this has been the main course in cinema for some time now, and there's not much sign of change on the horizon. We have had some original films that became blockbuster hits in the past years, but unfortunately they're few and far between. It's clear that what dominates the box office are what we know will be enjoyable, but we shouldn't just expect enjoyable, we should expect amazing, different, and most importantly of all, we should expect risk. Hardcore Henry was a risk. It asked the audience to come along for a 96-minute first-person action film where the main character doesn't talk, your biggest source of information is a dude playing several dudes, and where the action is wild, kinetic, and downright insane at times. It's unlike anything that has appeared in cinema, and still there hasn't been anything quite like it. But that's what makes it so one of a kind. This film, it isn't perfect. Far from it. As much as I have praised it, I understand the argument that the story is weak, the humor isn't funny, and that this perspective may just be too much for some people. But if you can look past these flaws, I believe you'll find that a truly special film lies beneath the surface. That's why I think you should buy Hardcore Henry. Because unfortunately, it seems that not a lot of people gave the time to watch it. The film made $16.8 million worldwide, which, while good against the $2 million budget, isn't anywhere near the numbers that mainstream films get to. But while the box office is long gone, we can still show Hollywood that more films like this, original with awesome stunts and action, are what we want. How? Simple. Share the love, buy the Blu-ray officially, tweet your support to the creators of this film, and talk about it in your film discussions. When someone mentions what are the great action films of today, alongside the usual suspects, why not mention Hardcore Henry? Movies like Trick or Treat have become cult classics, and others like Blade Runner have turned to film phenomenons despite being box office lightweights. They became so popular that all these years later they're finally making sequels to them. I think that if we show the same love and support for this film, not only do I think that it has the capacity to become embedded in cinematic history, but lead to more films like this, which give us a once-in-a-lifetime experience. If we all band together, we can transform Hardcore Henry from an underground hit to a mainstream phenomenon. Maybe this is too much to ask of someone. Maybe this film doesn't deserve the praise that I give it. But let me end it on this. Cinema is something that has made a mark on me unlike any other medium. And of the many films I've seen over the years, none have been more exciting, more unique, or more inspiring than Hardcore Henry. That is what makes this one of my favorite films of all time. That is why I think you should buy Hardcore Henry. That is why Hardcore Henry is awesome.